So I got curious, and being curious is a dangerous thing sometimes. The answer box tape is in Teddy right now. But that's not the answer box. That's Grubby. I'm curious to see what the coding for the answer box is going to do to poor Grubby here. So, one of two things I suspect will happen. One, it will either be fine and Grubby just won't animate because the signals are different, maybe. Or two, it's going to go horribly wrong. Grubby will start screaming from his speaker or something crazy, I don't know. But we will see what happens. I'm going to have my hand on the volume wheel to turn Teddy off just in case the latter happens. So, let's see.
Hello, my friend. This is Teddy. And we've got lots to learn already. Why don't you push the button?
So far, so good.
Red or yellow, green or blue.
The sound is coming out of Grubby's speaker, too. I don't know if it's obvious or not.
The answer box will answer you. It's lots of fun to play and learn. And the answer box gives you a turn. Why don't you push the button? Red or yellow, green or blue. Push the button. The answer box will answer you. Hi there. How are you? I'm glad you could join me for my new Teddy Ruxpin Answer Box story. Just push the button next to the picture which best answers the question I ask you. Push a button when you hear this sound.
It's weird seeing Grubby just kind of staring blankly
and always
and not blinking or animating or anything.
In this story, Grubby and I are giving a surprise party for a special guest. The party is going to start later this evening. But before everyone arrives, we want to clean and decorate the house for the party. As we get ready, we'll learn about numbers and counting. Gee, there's a number of things to do. Let's get started. Turn to page one. Did you turn the page? Boy, I'm glad we have just one house to clean for the surprise party. Can you see the one house on page one? Press the button next to the one house.
Oh, Grubby's mouth moved.
Uh-oh, that's not it. That's it.
The yellow button is next to the
Oh, that's interesting.
The house has one chimney and one window and one door. And there I am. Push the button next to the one picture of me.
Okay, so right here we're waiting for an input.
That's not Teddy. That's right.
The red button is next to the one
Half
picture
eyes
of me.
Closed
Let's
is
turn to page two.
Answer one.
Oh,
and
hi,
then
Grubby.
Eyes fully closed is answer two. That's really cool.
Up in the sky.
Oh, I see them too. Do you see the two birds? Count them. One, two. Press the button next to the two birds.
Okay, so here we go. Waiting for an input. Answer one.
Nope, you missed them.
Answer two.
Yep, there they go.
The blue button.
That's cool.
The two birds.
Okay, well, I don't know what this little experiment accomplished, but it certainly helped me understand how the signals translate from the motors to. I don't know. I don't know. It's all very, very interesting, and I'm not even going to pretend to understand how it works. But that's what happens when you plug Grubby into Teddy and play an answer box tape. Now we know.